Hello, and welcome to a quick demonstration of LUMOplay's advanced calibration tools. To access the advanced tools, go to the menu in the top left, select Preferences, and choose Calibrate. You can also access these tools by hitting F2 on your keyboard. The advanced calibration tools look similar to the regular calibration tools, but there are a few additional controls. While it is better to mask and flip your display area in the main calibration screen and not in this advanced screen, the mask and flip tools are available here if you need to make small adjustments. You can drag the blue corner pins to frame the interaction area, and you can also flip the tracked area vertically or horizontally if you notice that motion is being tracked on the wrong side of the interaction area. These sliders allow you to correct any angle differences between your camera and the surface you are projecting on. You adjust them until the wall or floor is an even shade. You can use this magic wand button to capture a snapshot of the camera angle. This will override any manual adjustments you have made, so it's best to start with this. This will also allow for better tracking of uneven surfaces. Adjusting the interpolation allows you to adjust differences in the depth data. By default, the interpolation is set to linear. This works well with most setups while being fairly forgiving if your calibration isn't perfect. In some cases, changing this setting will make tracking much more accurate. To configure most floor and wall setups, set the sensitivity to 0 before changing everything else. Readjust this at the end when the rest of the settings are adjusted. Clear the area of any objects that happen to be in view of the camera and that aren't normally there, like ladders, chairs, or people. Hit the magic wand button. You should immediately notice that the video feed looks a lot flatter now. Set the interpolation to step. Your video feed will either be entirely white or black now. This will give you the most accurate data, but requires precise configuration to work, which is why it must be adjusted manually. Define your detection range. For a floor, we recommend a 2-meter range. For motion-reactive walls, the ideal range will depend on how far away from the wall you want LUMOplay to detect people. For wall ball systems, set the range between 0.3 and 0.5 meters. Move the left distance slider until the range number here matches the range that you want to define. This will give you a visual indication of how far apart the left and right sliders need to be. Unfortunately, you can't move both sliders at the same time, so you will want to visually maintain the distance between these points as you make the next adjustment. Move both distance sliders until you see the screen transition from black to white, or vice versa. If the screen is all white, move the sliders to the left. If it's black, move them to the right. As mentioned before, you can only adjust one slider at a time, so you have to maintain your ideal range as best you can. When the sliders are in the correct place, use these arrow buttons to slightly step to the left with both distances until the screen is all black. This will allow us to see you when something is in the scene slightly away from the floor or wall. Slowly increase the sensitivity until it is as high as you can make it without the system responding to noise from the camera. If you are unable to set the sensitivity very high without the system reacting to motion that isn't there, you can increase the noise reduction a bit. It is usually ideal to set the noise reduction as low as possible so as to capture smaller movements. Always leave the delay slider at its minimum. This setting is only used for specific situations. Once you are satisfied with the calibration, hit the Done button and launch a game. If you still have questions, please head over to help.lumoplay.com